Hey guys, so today I'm here with a comparison between the next three iterations of Firefox. Ever since changing over to a much faster release cycle like Chrome, Mozilla has been hard at work cranking out new version after new version. To start with, we have the latest release version, Firefox 6. In the beta channel, we have the nearly complete Firefox 7. And lastly, still in alpha development, we have Firefox 8. The first test is going to be on memory usage. One of the biggest new features in Firefox 7 and 8 is improved handling of RAM, thanks to a new feature called MemShrink. As you can see here, it leads to a very nice improvement of roughly 25% less system resources needed to run the browser with 6 tabs. Next, we move on to the Peacekeeper benchmark. This is a fairly general overall test of browser performance, and as you can see here, Firefox 7 is a decent improvement over its predecessor. Surprisingly, Firefox 8 does a bit worse. However, as it is still in alpha, there's plenty of room for improvement before it's released. Continuing on, we have the V8 benchmark. This is a pure JavaScript test to determine how quickly a browser can load websites, such as Gmail. Here again, Firefox 7 and 8 do fairly well in posting a modest improvement. Getting away from the benchmarks, there are a few new features to go over as well. Firefox 7 is all about better performance with better garbage collection, CSS3 support, and improved password sync. Firefox 7 is on track to be released late September. Firefox 8 is a smaller update, largely focusing on Internet Explorer 9 style add-on notifications. Now, when you load the browser at first, it will offer to let you disable slow or unwanted add-ons. Overall, I'm quite impressed with what's on the way for Firefox. Version 7 brings a substantial jump in speed, as well as very welcome memory improvements that should help improve responsiveness and cut down on crashing. Firefox 8 is less impressive, however, as it's still in alpha, there's plenty of room for improvement before it's released. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a thumbs up, and if you're interested in more browser tests, be sure to subscribe to the channel.